Amiya, hello, 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 everybody. Welcome to tonight's grand show. I guess it is Amiya, you know. My stream is not later than it normally is, although it kind of feels that way. Probably because I actually woke up at a decent hour today. Wishing you a good stream. Thanks, Kyle. The amazing Mr. Mistopheles. No, that's not who I'm dressed as right now. hi everybody, this is your dream event. Song of sing song in Spider Mama. And you put on your best suit. Oh, stain with barbecue sauce. Oh, you're telling a fib. how many buckles fit in there? I'd say about around 4 or 5 could probably fit in there. Yeah, I think so. No, no, I'm not a mayor. I'm even something even scarier than Mayor Ami. If you can believe it. This is a little hat for my first costume that I'm gonna wear tonight for the first song. you can squish them down. I mean, I think 5 would be with them pretty dang squished. A hat that can contain the... Oh, yeah. But the screen cannot contain my hat, it seems. Not Monopoly. Many costumes, well, I tried to... Okay, so... I didn't have time to, like, draw a bunch of costumes. But I tried to find as many costumes as I could for the different songs. Not every song has, like, a costume or accessory involved. But some of them do. And I have Gatorade. So that's pretty cool. Thank you for your guys' request for this karaoke. I picked a lot of songs that you guys sent that I thought that I liked and I thought I could learn. There are some songs that are sung by like many people, which is, you know, difficult for me. I have a couple that have like a few roles, but you know, it's tough. I'm one gal, you know. And what was I gonna say? And then I have some of the ones I wanted to sing near the end. So that way, if my voice is like meh, 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 I'll get to your guys' request first, you know. Musicals aren't known to make songs easy to sing. No, but I am amazing. You know, I was thinking today about like musicals or like school plays and stuff, and you guys know how like dramatic and like animated and like how much fun I have trying to play like different roles and do different voices and stuff, and how much fun I have singing. I always been like that, you know. And I would audition for the school play whenever I could. I never ever got picked for a role. It was so sad. It was so sad. One time, I remember in... No, it's okay. It's not like... It's silly, you know. It's just... I got like side roles, you know. But never like speaking roles. So what happened one year... I was in grade 6. And we were doing Snow White. And... you were a cow, Jason. Aw, that's a fun role. Were you like half of a cow? No, it wasn't a bush. So it was Snow White. So I was like a lady in waiting to the evil queen. But there was like this whole scandal because I remember that there was 2 different grade 6 classes. This was so long ago, but I still like remember this particular specific part because it was like... It was such a big deal. There's 2 different grade 6 classes. And one of them was the one I was in. And the other one, the teacher of that class, was in charge of the drama department. And all of the lead roles... went to people from that class. Some 6th grade drama. So we were all kind of like, and kind of rigged. But I don't know, you know. I don't know if that's, you know. But everyone in my class was like, what the frick? Except we didn't say what the frick. We probably said, I don't know what we would have said. I don't know. Oh, I would do the same for you guys. That's the thing. I mean, not if I was in school, but you know. If I was doing an audition and it was Buckles and then everyone else, I'd prioritize Buckles. But you can't do that stuff in school, kids. Come on. Biased drama teachers. Yeah, but that's okay because look at me now. I've got 200 people here right now, and that's more than was at the Ding Dang School play for sure. And I get to sing to all you guys. I was a little bit of a teacher's pet, yeah. You're forced to do drama in each grade and lucked out playing one of the only non-singing roles. Playing the narrator is always fun. Narrator is fun. I don't even think you'd have to appear. Oh, and also about tonight's karaoke. I noticed a lot of people were sending songs from like movie musicals. I'm only doing songs that are like stage musicals, but I can do another karaoke down the line that's with those other like movie based musicals and stuff. You can definitely do that. Now I'm the drama queen on stage. I'm a drama queen. I don't think I'm too much of a drama queen. Maybe sometimes unintentionally, you know. You played a rock. I was the lady in waiting to the queen. Well, I can do like... Also, I'm gonna skip hellos today to just say my voice and stuff. I could do Bet on it, bet on it. That's a good High School Musical song. No Phantom of the Opera music. I almost sang Phantom of the Opera, like the song Phantom of the Opera, but I can't do. The girl does this like insane like high note at the end, and I just can't do that high. But I do consider it. Anyway, yeah. Aren't most movie musicals originally stage plays? Not all of them. The ones that were, I was like, okay, yeah, I'll do this song, you know? Because some people sent ones from like Chicago, and I was like, well, that's like, that's a movie, but it's based on like the musical. She's so talented, right? It's such a great song. It's amazing, but yeah, I can't do that. thanks for the 10 months, Fanology. Phantom is Weber, yeah. It's so good. Wonder if there are any Sonic songs at Google on these kinds of stages. I've done a Sonic karaoke if that's what you're looking for. So South Park musical songs are... I can't think of a single appropriate South Park song. Shut your meowing face, Uncle Meower. Playing Canada. Oh my god. Is there a Sonic stage play? There definitely should be, right? You could have submitted a song for the Pokemon musical. You could have. You forgot about Shrek the musical? Well, don't worry. I didn't. Fashion Bond, thanks for the 14 months. Ami, hi, Ami. Work's been crazy lately, but I'm glad to catch this. Ami love, Buckle love. Thank you. Welcome. Alright, I guess we can get to the first song then. Let me turn my reverb on. And maybe this hat will be a hint to some of you. Bendy Neko, thanks for the 10 months. Looking forward to the singing, but I'll have to learn today. No worries, no worries. I hope you enjoy. Thanks for saying hi. And thank you to everybody who is stopping in. I saw a couple of people say they can't stay. They can't stick around, but I appreciate you guys stopping in and saying hi regardless. Thank you so much. Am I all reverbed up? Oh, I also I'm gonna do my thing. Right, lower everyone's expectations and then probably do fine anyway, but there's like 5 buckles in this hat. I wouldn't say my voice is in the best shape today. But I think I'll do fine. But you know. Don't expect an actual musical leader performance, okay? Buckles in the chat. Meow, meow. Alright. So let me get my lyrics up here. And I'll turn off my bugum. And I will open this. Oh wait, I have to do something. that up. And I open this. Okay. I'll do my best.
Feeling of power and drive, I've never known. I feel alive with just this feeling of power drive, making me know why I'm alive. Like the night, it's a secret, sinister, dark, and unknown. I do not know what I seek, yet I'll seek it alone. I have a thirst that I cannot deprive. Never have I felt so alive. There is no battle I couldn't survive. Feeling like this, feeling alive. Like the moon, an enigma, lost and alone in the night. Damned by some heavenly stigma, but blazing with light. It's the feeling of being alive, filled with evil but truly alive. It's the truth that cannot be denied. It's the feeling of being Edward Hyde. Wait, what's this? Sweet miss, I thought I had lost you. It's fate. What bliss, sweet miss. Your folly will cost you dear, my dear. You see, you never escape me. I'm here. I fear, and you will pay dear, my dear. Like a raging desire, fills my whole soul with its curse, burning with primitive fire, berserk and perverse. Tonight, I'll plunder heaven blind, steal from all the gods tonight. I'll take from all mankind, conquer all the odds, and I feel I live on forever with Satan. Himself by my side, and I'll show the world that tonight and forever the name to remembers the name Edward Hyde. What a feeling to be so alive. I have never seen me so alive. Such a feeling of evil inside. It's the feeling of being Edward Hyde.
It's a very spicy! Wow, this instrumental... This instrumental just goofed me. There's a whole verse missing. There's one where he goes, being Edward Hyde at the feeling of being alive. and so because I'm... So because of that, I didn't get to do the Edward Hyde at the end. Oh well. Welcome, welcome. Hellfire will not be on the playlist. That's not from a musical, but... I have... sung Hellfire before in karaoke. Ba-ba-ba-bum. A good start, right? What do you guys think? You're so lost that went to applause. You can applause after every song. So that was... Yeah, I got my miscellaneous growling in. That was Alive. From... what's it called? Just... I feel like... It's more than just Jekyll and Hyde, right? Well, you guys will know what I mean. I feel like it's something crazy like the Mysterious Venture. Oh, Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. Jekyll, Jekyll, Hyde, Jekyll, Hyde, Hyde, Jekyll. You're amazing. Thank you. Thank you. We're gonna continue on. I have to change my hat though. This is very important, you guys. The hat changes are... possibly the most important, yet also silly thing to come out of this whole karaoke. So give me a schmeck on. My hat. Aha! Whoa, it's huge! I'm just like curious, wondering if people can like guess the songs based on the hat, you know what I mean? I feel like that's a fun game to play. Ah, stay on hat. Okay, that's good enough. Alright. It's not... there's no Jumanji musical. If there is there? Is there a Jumanji musical? The hat is a little misleading. I will be totally honest. I wanted to find a different, better hat. But this one is like... anyway, I don't even know if you guys will know the connection once I start playing the music, but... let's mute this up. Okay. This one's very, very difficult to sing. Bring this over here. It's not even really singing. It's kind of like so fast that's like rapping, you know? There's no ties in musical, I don't think. You'll see. Oh, somebody got it. Okay, I'll do my best.
I am the very model of a modern major general. I've information, vegetable, animal, and mineral. I know the kings of England and I quote the fights historical. From Marathon to Waterloo in order categorical. I'm very well acquainted too with matters mathematical. I understand equations both the simple and quadratical. About binomial theorem, I am teeming with a lot of news. Ah, a lot of news, huh? Oh, got it! Oh, with many cheerful facts about the square of the hypotenuse. I'm very good at integral and differential calculus. I know the scientific names of beings and animalculus. In short, it matters vegetable, animal, and mineral. I am the very model of a modern major general.
No, the next one's the one I'm bad at.
I know our mythic history, King Arthur's answer paradox. I answer hard acrostics, I have a pretty tasteful paradox. I quote in elegiacs and the crimes of Heliogabalus. In conics, I can float peculiarities parabolus. I can tell and Dr. Raphael's from Jared Allison's Zophanies. I know a croaking chorus from the frogs of Aristophanes. And I can hum a fugue with which I've heard the music's dinner for. Whew, dinner for. I got it. And whistle all the airs from that infernal nonsense pinafore! Then I can write a washing bill in Babylonic uniform and tell you every detail of Karatakus's uniform. In short, it matches vegetable, animal, and mineral. I am the very model of a modern major general. In fact, when I know what is meant by mamelon and ravelin, when I can tell at sight a mouse or rifle from a javelin, when such affairs as sorties and surprises I'm more wary at, and when I know precisely what is meant by commissariat, when I have learned what progress has been made in modern gunnery, when I know more of tactics than a novice in a nunnery, in short, when I have a smattering of elemental strategy.
Oh, I say strategy. Oh, that's a hard one. I've got it.
You'll say a better major general has never strategy!
You'll say a better major general has never strategy! You'll say a better major general has never strategy!
my military knowledge, though I'm plucky and adventury, has only been brought down to the beginning of the century. But still it matters, vegetable, animal, and mineral. I am the very model of a modern major general.
Bring it in. Ah, yes, presto agitato, if you play, maestro.
In fact, when I know what is meant by mammalon and ravelin, when I can tell a side of master travel,
where we am, when I know precisely. I gotta go back. We're gonna have the whole pause again, okay? I'm gonna do it. I did this. I never messed up in this part. It's so upsetting. It's always the middle part. Ah, yes. Presto agitato, si vous plaît, maestro.
In fact, when I know what is meant by mammalon and ravelin, when I can tell it's a master rifle from a javelin, with such affairs, sorties, and surprises, I'm a wariat. And when I know precisely what is meant by commissariat. When I have learned what progress has been made in modern gunnery, when I know more of tactics than a novice in a nunnery, in short, when I've a smattering of elemental strategy, you'll save a better major general as ever on a horse!
Ah, okay.
For my military knowledge, though I'm plucky and adventury, has only been brought down to the beginning of the century. Still, it matches vegetable, animal, and mineral. I am the very model of a modern major general.
Is this from Reboot? You know, I knew it from... Some people say it was in Mass Effect. Mass Effect, which I learned later. But I knew it... I had heard it in... Animaniacs. It was like a... I am the very model of a cartoon something or other. I am the very model of a modern major general. This is from Pirates of... How do you spell it? Panzak? Is that gonna fit? No. Oh, Riding Soul! Thank you so much for the 5 gifted memberships! Please say thank you to Riding Soul, take out one! Thank you! Bako! And Gildrian, thank you so much for the super chat! Watching you for more than a year! And just the first song is like watching you sing... for the first time! Aww. And Crashy, thank you so much for the super chat! I forgot my ticket! Mitz... not free show, right? It is a free show, of course. It's gotta disappear, though. After. It's unarchived, so, timing sounds good? Okay, perfect. So... archivists... onegai. Okay! I looked at the Mass Effect clip, and it's like... It's funny, because it's like buried in a whole line... Like a sub-line of dialogue. You got one going, thank you! Fear is gonna be demolished. Yeah, this fear is coming down. Alright, enough of this hat. I got another costume to put on. That's not this hat. The next costume is pretty iconic. I wonder if anyone will know. So this song... I listen to a lot, but... I wouldn't say that I like properly practiced it. So... we'll see what happens. It's a vest, but it's supposed to be a blazer, okay? I just want you to keep that in mind. Oh, and also this next song has some foul language, okay? Is that a seal? I don't know what it is. I don't know what the insignia is. It has some profane language, so please don't be too shocked. Okay, everyone just chill. I'm telling you in advance to chill, okay? Hold on to your, your pearls. Hold on to your butt. Okay. No, 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 no. Karaoke and music does not count for the swear jar, okay? And also, I don't need a swear jar. People who need a swear jar are people who swear a lot and are trying not to swear. I never swear. I never swear, and sometimes you try and you guys try and get me to swear. Don't hold my butt. Hold on to your CDI. Sure, sure, sure. Meow, meow. Alright. This is one I actually saw when it was like, it's like on YouTube for somehow. And it's really, really good. And I really like the movie. Well, it's based off a novel, but I really enjoyed the movie for like a long, long time. So I thought it was so cool that it got musical. Okay. How many classes? I don't know, several. Also, there's a speaking part at the beginning. Well, I'm not sure. Oh, are we gonna have a problem? You got a bone to pick? You've come so far. Why now are you pulling on my dick? I normally slap your face off, and everyone here can watch. But I'm feeling nice. Here's some advice. Listen up, biatch. Looking hot, buying stuff they cannot. Drinking hard, maxing dad's credit card. Skipping gym, scaring her, screwing him. Killer clothes. If you lack the balls, you can go play dolls. Let your mommy fix you a snack. Or you could come smoke, pound some rum and coke in my Porsche with the quarterback. Honey, what you waiting for? Welcome to my candy store. Time for you to prove you're not a loser anymore. To step into my candy store. Guys, at your feet, pay the check, help you cheat. All you have to do, say goodbye to Shamu. Not your friend, I can tell in the end. If she had your shot, she would leave you to rot. Cause if you don't care, fine, go braid her hair. Maybe Sesame Street is on. Or forget that creep and get in my Jeep. Let's go tear up someone's lawn. Honey, what you waiting for? Welcome to my candy store. You just gotta prove you're not a pussy anymore. Just step into my candy store. You can join the team or you can bitch and moan. You can live the dream or you can die alone. You can fly with eagles or if you prefer, keep on testing me. Step into my candy store. Ah, ah, ah. Step into my candy store. It's my candy store. It's my candy. It's my candy store. It's my candy. It's my candy store. It's my candy store. Good job, Ami. I was really worried about that run, but I think I nailed it. What do you guys think? Punch, punch, punch. Thank you. So that was Candy Store from Heathers. It's actually not my favorite song from the Heathers musical, but I do like it a lot. And the one that I actually like, shut up, Heather. The one that I actually like is like 1,000 times more profane. So, you know, I just decided to go with Candy Store. And someone requested it, so... Chocolate mint candies? Ooh, Junior Mint. You still think that a scene blows my mind every time? Ooh! The movie would be great. Watch along. I love it. It's so, such a, like a crazy dark movie, though. you heard that song a long time before you saw the musical. It's disappointing that it was a lot less gay than the Anakin line. What the heck? Never heard that before. You put such a grin on my face singing that. I hope you guys didn't. I hope that the cursing and stuff wasn't too much of a problem. Sorry. It's a great musical though. I love Heathers. And a great movie too. And probably a great book. I don't know. Okay, let me take this laser off. Do I have a costume for my next one? I'm not sure. Hi guys, everyone who's coming in. I'm kind of getting off to like a roaring start here. Kind of just like ripping through it. My sister doesn't know what VTubers are, but if she was here, she'd be hyped as hell. She's a theater geek. I wouldn't say that I'm actually a theater geek, you know, but maybe another world timeline. Oh, ooh. I do have a hat for this. I do. It's like a, you know, like kind of like a... What should we call this? 20s? Like a... flapper number, perhaps? 1920s? Does that give you guys any hints? Oh, let me put up the candy store. This one I kind of learned last minute, so I hope it's, alright. The roaring 20s, like a flapper meal, yeah. Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, the keeper of the keys, the countess of the clink, the mistress of murderer's row, matron Mama Morta.
Ask any of the chickies in my pen, they'll tell you I'm the biggest mother hen. I love them all, and all of them love me. Because the system works, the system called reciprocity. Got a little motto, always sees me through. When you're good to mama, mama's good to you. There's a lot of favors I'm prepared to do. You do one for mama, she'll do one for you. They say that life is tit for tat, and that's the way I live. So I deserve a lot of tat for what I've got to give. Don't you know that this hand washes that one too? When you're good to mama, mama's good to you. If you want my gravy, pepper my ragu, spice it up for mama, she'll get hot for you. When they pass that basket, folks contribute too. You put in for mama, she'll put out for you. The folks atop the ladder are the ones the world adores. So boost me up, my ladder kid, and I'll boost you up yours. Let's all stroke together like the Princeton crew. When you're stroking mama, mama's stroking you. So what's the one conclusion I can bring this number to? When you're good to mama. Mama's got
Okay. That was, what is the name of that song? That's from Chicago. Which, I know there's like a very famous Chicago movie from 2002. And I've actually never... Yeah, someone, a buck requested that one. Can you believe it? I can. There is a very famous movie, When You're Good to Mama, it's called. But, I actually never seen it, which is kind of surprising. I learned that pretty last minute, yeah. Because I had another Chicago song in mind, and then... Oh, Kinetic, thanks for the 10 gifted memberships! Thank you! Say thank you to Kinetic if you got one, guys. Thank you very much. I learned that one kind of last minute. I had a different Chicago song I was trying to learn. And when I was looking at the, like... It has a lot of spoken bits, and when I was looking at like the karaoke video, it didn't really line out where the spoken bits were supposed to go very well. So I ended up switching to this. The other one I was gonna do was Cell Block Tango, which is a cool song. How did they fit so much vocal power into one little slider? Who is they? I just you know. I practiced lots of... Alright. Singing is always so mesmerizing. Thank you! I wish I did a little bit better on the low notes on that one, but... you know. Trying to figure out if I have... Oh, I have something in mind for an encore too. Have you found a good instrumental for this one? It's a really good song by itself. Yeah, the instrumental... Sadly, it had a little bit of, like... Backing vocals on it. Like guide vocals. But it was the best one I found. You sung some Sinatra before. This gives similar Chicago vibes. Oh, yeah.
Just what makes that little old ant think he'll move a rubber tree plant? Everyone knows an ant can't move a rubber tree plant. But he's got high hopes.
I like Sinatra. Amiya, are you there? Yeah, I'm here. What do you mean? Oh god, this next song is so hard and so high. Also, I don't have a costume for it, but I am gonna change into, this outfit. Because it's kind of closer to what the character would be wearing, so... Is that from the hit musical Ants? You know, they did actually use the song in Ants in the ending credits. They did actually use that song in Ants, and that might be why I know it. I'm sorry. I do really like Frank Sinatra, though I know a lot of other Frank Sinatra.
That's life. That's what all the people say.
It's not encyclopedic knowledge, okay? It's a coincidence. I'm not an ants girl. Unia Deet? Oh. This one I had a lot of trouble learning too. There's specifically a part with like a slow, kind of like vibrato part. But it was kind of hard to learn. Kinetic, it's okay. They meant Beetlejuice when they said that abbreviation. Spoilers, it is from Beetlejuice. So, they weren't just like throwing that out there, you know? No, it's okay, I understand the confusion. Alright. Oh, I need to pitch this down. Hold on. Transpose down one. Okay.
Hey, mom. Then, mom, I need a little help here. Probably talking to myself here. But then, mom, I gotta ask, are you really in the ground? 'Cause I feel you all around me. Are you here, dead mom? Dead mom. Dead mom. I'm tired of trying to iron out my creases. I'm a bunch of broken faces. It was you who made me whole. Every day that's staring at me. Let go, hurry. Move along, forget about your mom. 'Cause daddy's in denial, daddy doesn't wanna be. He wants me to smile and clap like I'm performing.
On the lyric video. And like the timing is like a little bit off. I'm not dead. Hi guys.
Whatever it takes to make him say your name, dead mom.
That's how the end's supposed to sound. Alright, so that is it. I hit the じゃあ、朝ごはん食べましたか？Bye, mom. Thank you. I'm not dead. You seem so good. It's unreal, beautiful. Oh, stop, you guys. Okay. Dead mom. I've never seen Beetlejuice musical. I really, really want to. I don't know if it's been released for, like, video or anything yet. Is there anyone who can watch it? Does anyone know? Maybe I should have warned you guys that this song is called, Dead Mom, you know? Sorry if I got anyone off guard. It's kind of like sad, but it's kind of like a little bit comedic in a way, I guess. I mean, it's Beetlejuice vibes. It's got that like morbid, black comedy kind of feeling. How many more mom songs? That's the last mom song, I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure. I don't know if anyone suggested that because of, the the mom part for that one though. let me hug you guys just in case. How does small cute spooner sing so big? I don't know. Voice had a big voice, you know. Big voice, little spooner. I think it's a nice, I think it's a nice little, like, gap. You know? Gap. This is likely it's because of the watch along. Oh, yeah, we did watch that. And it's a very large gap. Very large gap. But thank you, comrades, for the donation. Someone probably suggested do the watch along. We have Beal and Beetlejuice 2 coming out next year. What? Beetlejuice 2? The frick. I don't know. Okay. We'll see how it turns out. Alright. Let me check the set list here. Oh, I have a costume for this. Hold on. Yeah, unnecessary decades later sequels usually do not bode well, but I don't know, it could be fine. I don't know if I'm gonna be that good at this song. It's kind of very complicated to sing. There's a lot going on. Several voices. I didn't mean to tilt myself. Alright. You don't need to shave. You said anything about shaving. I will confess that I've only ever seen the Sweeney Todd movie, but I love the story of Sweeney Todd. Yeah, the costume... This costume is like, I might as well not even keep it from you guys, cause... I'll do my best with this song. It's very, very difficult. Okay. I need to pitch this up 3 times. Right? I think. Yeah. Hi, mom. Hi, your mom. Okay. Ouch, ouch, I say. Oh, this running and shouting. What is it now? I had him, and then the sailor burst in. I saw them both running down the street, and I had him. His throat was bare beneath my hand. There, don't fret. No, I had him. His throat was there, now he'll never come again. Easy now. Hush, love, hush. I keep telling you, what's your rush? Why did I wait? You told me to wait. Now he'll never come again. There's a hole in the world like a great black pit, and it's filled with people who are filled with shit, and the vermin of the world inhabit it. But not for long. They all deserve to die. Tell you why, Mrs. Lovett, tell you why. Because in all of the whole human race, Mrs. Lovett, there are 2 kinds of men, only 2. The one staying put in his proper place, and the one with his foot in the other one's face. Look at me, Mrs. Lovett, look at you. No, we all deserve to die. Even you, Mrs. Lovett, even I. Because the lives of the wicked should be made brief. For the rest of us, death will be a relief. We all deserve to die. And never see Joanna. No, I'll never hug my girl to me. Finished! Alright, you sir, how about a she? Come and visit your good friend Sweeney. You sir, too sir, welcome to the grave. I will have vengeance. I will have salvation. Who, sir? You, sir? No one's in the chair. Come on, come on! Sweeney's waiting. I want you bleeders.
you, sir. Anybody. Gentlemen, now don't be shy. Not one man, no, nor 10 men, not 100 can assuage me. I will have you. And I will get him back, even as he gloats. In the meantime, I'll practice on less honorable throats. And my Lucy lies in ashes, and I'll never see my girl again. But the work waits. I'm alive at last, and I'm full of joy.
Spooky song. Oh my god, the the change back to my BGM is such whiplash. I tried it like the very, very last second tonight to try and find a BGM that was a little more calm and jazzy, but then I ran out of time and I had to go. That is a difficult song. I hope I did okay. It's very difficult. I probably could have pitched it up one more, to be honest. But I did it. I feel like earlier I was doing the low notes a lot better than I am right now.
And I'll never see Joanna.
You want empanadas? I don't think there's empanadas in Sweeney Todd, isn't it? Pies. Isn't it London's worst pie? What a shame, please, still! You still want a shame, eh? You sound a phenomenal thing? Thank you, thank you. Yeah, there is a lot of quick tempo switching, a lot of key switching. It's in kind of like a maniacal kind of key, you know. I'll be singing something from Wicked. I know one Wicked song that I might be able to sing as an encore. You guys can remind me. It's really hard though. Buckles pies. Ami's buckle pies that only she makes and only she eats. Exactly. You mean it's in the Ami key? My key is not maniacal, okay? I'm in like the key of like B major. Yeah, I know the fine gravity. That's the only one though, I think. Okay, let's get rid of straight razor. I, needless to say, do not know how to give a shave. So, more than likely, if I try and shave you guys' faces, it's gonna end up... You're gonna end up in a meat pie, okay? I'll just say that. It's called... Epiphany. Sweeney Todd. Is it Sweeney Todd's Demon Barbershop? Sweeney Todd the Demon Barber of Fleet Street. Fleet Street! You don't want a razor near your neck. Well, if a professional, you know. It's quite the jump from a shave. Well, you guys know Sweeney Todd. Please. Alright. But no. Wow, I'm like halfway through the set list and I've been streaming for only like an hour. Not even. I know, I don't usually like talk much between... Oh, this next one's super fun! Between songs for karaoke. We can do some more though. I have an encore one planned already and then... Okay, this one was not a request. This was a selfish, self-pick, you know. But... I always really, really like this song. The secret known only few yet should be known to many. Ami's indeed supportive, cute, and amazing, and sings like an angel and not a crab. That's so sweet. I don't know how you would sing like a crab. Ram from any license to do straight razor shaves. I'm pretty sure it's to avoid Sweeney Todd situations. I mean, it's great that you need a license, but I doubt they're doing like... psychological checks to give them to people. I don't know how you would avoid Sweeney Todd. It's probably something like people can't just offer it willy-nilly and actually accidentally hurt someone. Same as like normal cosmetic products like bleach and stuff like that. I don't think it's to be like, oh, we don't want people... we don't want people, killing other people while giving them a straight razor shave. As someone, they think of the movie Sweeney Todd as a terrible idea. Yeah, that's a surefire way to get your license application rejected right away. Okay. No question for this. I could not find a pompadour, so... We're going with, wait, did I get rid of my, I got rid of my razor already. Don't remember doing that. I have to put this up, plus two. Wow, this car is automatic. It's systematic. It's hydromatic. Why? It's Grease Lightning.
Grease Lightning!
We'll get some overhead lifters and four barrel quads, oh yeah.
Keep talking, walk, keep talking.
Fuel injection cut off and chrome braided rods, oh yeah. With our voice being on the floor, they'll be waiting at the door. You know that ain't no shit, but they'll be getting lots of tit and grease lighting.
Go,
grease lighting, you're burning up the quarter mile.
Grease lighting, go, grease lighting.
Go, grease lighting, you're coasting through the heel of dryer.
Grease lighting, go, grease lighting.
You are supreme, the chicks will cream. Go, grease lighting. We'll get some purple French taillights and 30-inch fittings, oh yeah. A Palomino dashboard and dual muffled twins, oh yeah, yeah. With new pistons, plugs, and shocks, I can get off my rocks. You know that I ain't bragging, she's a real pussy wagon. Grease lightning.
Go,
grease lightning, you're burning up the quarter. Cream for grease lightning.
Dance, 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 oh! Korean breath dance, break, everybody!
Oh yeah!
Everybody in the car! I'm in Hawaii, baby! Hop on! Hop in even! What the heck is going on? Right, but it's also a musical, right? But I was looking at like the musical playlist, and I guess You're the one that I want? It's not in the original one, although they did add it later. Isn't that interesting? I thought that was so interesting. I love that song. You're the one that I want? My aunt thinks it's also a country, that's true. My aunt thinks it goes, you're the one that I want? John Travolta. Because John Travolta's in the movie. You haven't seen Grease, but your cousin said he hated it. It's a great movie. Your cousin's wrong. Your cousin's wrong, Mother Meower. Didn't realize how suggestive this song is before now. You didn't know when you were younger and watched it, you didn't think about it. You never saw it and you hate it. Well, that's just dumb. Wrong opinion! you didn't remember when they said it'll make all the girls. You know. Have I heard the clean version? No, I don't think it's clean or not. In the movie. I think you probably just didn't know what you were hearing. The Lion King would count as musical theater, and I do have a song from The Lion King on my encore list. So we'll see how that goes. You watch as a teen and somehow didn't notice. I don't think that word is something that's like in the common vernacular. Now, getting your rocks off or whatever, that's a little bit more, you know, common colloquial, I guess. Greased lightning. Grease. Alright, I've been drinking a lot of freaking Gatorade Zero. So I have to pee now. Can you guys please me, go grease lightning go while I'm gone, alright? did you guys really mean did I tip out of existence for a second? Are we good? Try refreshing if you're having problems. Thank you, Heart and Gento and Red Ranger and Lupus and Benjamin and Finite Set and Riding Soul and Peppermint and Turbo and Stitch for the blue super chats while I was gone. Thank you. Because I'm Amiya. Thanks, guys, for waiting and for being Grease Lightning.
Grease Lightning.
What the heck is next? Oh, I don't have a costume for this, but I wish I had time to draw one. I don't know anything about this musical. But I have heard the name before. And this song is very chill. I don't know, it gives me 70s vibes. So like, maybe this musical is like a 70s thing? I don't really know. But I'm sure some of you guys know it and you'll be able to tell me. Once we get started. Wait, hold on, I gotta start it over. I don't know where I put my lyrics tab. Here we go. And I need to pitch this up one.
I close my eyes, drew back the curtain to see for certain what I thought I knew. Far, far away, someone was weeping, but the world was sleeping. Any dream will do. I wore my coat with golden lining, bright colors shining, wonderful. My golden coat grew out of sight. The colors faded into darkness. I was left alone. May I return to the beginning. The light is dimming and the dream is true. And I, we are still waiting, still hesitating. Any dream can do.
Is it so pleasant? Feel good vibes.
Ooh, oh, a crash of drums, a flash of light. My golden coat flew out of sight. The colors faded into darkness. I was left alone. May I return hesitating. Any dream will do. Any dream will do.
at myself at the end. That's not in the original song, as far as I know. Oh god, this time... Okay. I wanna know... Who the heck requested this next song? Cause... I learned it and everything, cause I was like, this is such a fun... Like... upbeat... type song. And, I like learned it. I went on my way to learn it. And then I looked it up. Oh, that was, Any Dream Will Do from Joseph and the Technicolor Dream Coat. A few requests are closed. I took requests for a couple weeks, actually. It's a perfect number for a dream with Spider-Mama, right? Any dream will do. Well, if it's a buckle dream. It was originally made for a school play in the 60s, and after Andrew Lloyd Webber got big in the 70s, he turned into a full musical. Aww. Super nostalgic for me. Thanks for singing it, of course. And the amazing... Sorry, I forgot. How could I forget that it's an amazing Technicolor Dream Coat? Hold on. There we go. Yeah, that's like a Dreamweaver-ish song. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, so I learned this next song. And I was like, this is so silly and fun. And it's got like a funny word in it, you know? It's like perfect for my potty humor brain. And then I like looked up an instrumental. And I saw... Family Guy rendition. And I was like, who the heck sent me a song? So now... I already have the song on my set list, but now people are gonna think I am like, you know... Family Guy... You know... Like, this was something I did. Now it's gonna further cement my reputation as a Family Guy VTuber, which is a reputation I don't want. I don't even like Family Guy, okay? No! See what's happening? So I had to tell you guys that because... Otherwise... Hey, always remember that time with this Fire Girl karaoke? Honestly, I'd rather be the Sonic VTuber than either Ants or Family Guy. And I'd rather be the Family Guy VTuber than the Ants VTuber. Not Family Girl, no. Oh my god, I drooled. I'm so sorry. It's not from Family Guy, though. It was just in Family Guy, you know. I don't have anything to do with that.
It seems today that all you see...
Anyway, you'd rather have a lie of a title than a true one. It's not true! Sloth VTuber, Sonic VTuber, Family Guy VTuber, Ants VTuber. Yeah, that's the hierarchy. I'm the Ants girl no more. Yeah. Anyway, this is Shupoopy. Do I have to pitch this at all? I don't think so. Oh, I hold on. I missed my timing.
Well, a woman who kissed on the very first date is usually a hussy. And a woman who kissed on the second time out is anything but fussy. But a woman who waits till the third time around, head in the clouds, feet on the ground, she's the girl he's glad he's found. She's his Shupoopy, 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 the girl who's hard to get. Shupoopy, 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 but you can win her yet. Walk her once just to raise the curtain, walk around twice and you make for certain. Once more with a flower garden, she never gets sore if you beg her pardon. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, si, do, si, la, sol, fa, mi, re. Don't squeeze her once, but she isn't looking. If you squeeze back, she's fancy cooking. Once more for a pet, for apple, she will never get sore on her way to supper. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, si, do, si, do. That little old town, she's an old gal, as anyone can see. Look at her now, she's an old gal who only goes for me. But she isn't looking. Get a squeeze back, that's fancy cooking. Once more for a pepper apple, she will never get salt on her way to supper. Re, mi, fa, sol, la, si, do, si, do. Shupoopy, 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 the girl who's hard to get. Shupoopy, 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 but you can't win her yet.
Woohoo! instrumental break is like 3 minutes long. So I'm gonna do a slow fade out. This has a big ol' instrumental break. Yeah, you gotta have the dance parts. I mean, I was dancing, but I could only dance so much before I started to go crazy, you know. Yeah, that is Whiplash from the last song. So that's the poopy from The Music Man. Yeah, they ended just like that. I had nothing to do with it. Shapoopy. The Music Man. How many times have I told you no showboating? See, I only know that that's a Family Guy reference because I watched a clip today. That's such a weird song selection. Ah, it's a fun little song. I mean, it's like goofy, you know. Shapoopy, come on. You watch the episode of Family Guy after the stream? See, they have to, sponsor me. I'm pressing manage to say it over 3 times before giggling. Shapoopy, shapoopy, shapoopy. Oh, man. Cedric finally is a huge fan of musicals and references them all the time in his shows. Shapoopy. Who came up with the word shapoopy? It's like, why would you choose a word, that means like, that means like... like... a girl you want to date. Shapoopy. Why would you put poop in there? I know that's a really, really, really old musical, but surely they knew what the word poop meant back then. I know it was the 50s, but come on. Come on, they knew about poop in the 50s. Come on, don't tell me that they didn't know the poop word. Oh, shapoopy. Oh, you're my little shapoopy. You're my little shapoopy. Oh. Oh, what a little shapoopy you are. Oh, that's a cute shapoopy. People like to call their people their Pooh Bear. Well, Pooh is different than poop. Pooh is kind of cute. Poop is. Anyway, enough. Enough. I'm not gonna say that word anymore. Okay. The next one is a song that I really wanted to sing. But. I'm having trouble with this one part in the song. So I don't know if I will perform it properly. Somebody suggested a song from this musical, but the song was like, too difficult, you know? Hold on. So I went for a different song from this musical because I really, really, really like this musical, but there's one part I don't think I'll be able to do, but, I'm gonna like phone it in, you know. Next song will be The Great Mighty Pooh. No, I had that thrust upon me. I did not organically come across that song, okay? Somebody forced me to listen to it. Alright. But I love, 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 love. This is like my favorite musical and one of my favorite movies. Okay. All of this time I planned I'd be patient and you would love me again. You'd come to respect my mind and at last you'd find you could love me again. And I have turned my whole world upside down, trying not to let you go. Watching you walk away is like a fatal blow. Whoa! Is that my name up on that list? Does someone know that I exist? Is this a mistake? Am I even awake? Pinch me now to make sure. Ow! Yes, that's my name in black and white. I must be doing something right. Whoa! I feel so much better than before. What? Sorry, I've been
test, but I guess my best was not working with you. But it looks like I found a cure, and I so look forward to working with you.
What? Working with you?
Hey, remember when we spent spring break in the hot tub every night?
Every night.
We said nothing else could ever feel so right. Well, this might see my name up on that list. But that is the first time that we kissed. You thought I was dumb, but I think that somebody's judgment was poor. Cause I am so much better than before.
Yes, she's so much better.
Maybe she's what you prefer, but hey, last year I was her. Maybe you will change your mind, but you might look up to find I've gone on to better things, better jobs or bigger wings. I don't have that time to cry. I'm too busy loving my name up on that list. Kind of a cool ironic twist. Who else can I tell? Fall on the floor. Hey mom, look at my name in black and white. Your daughter's doing something right. I like this song, I feel so much better. I'll be there on Monday, 9 o'clock. Then we will see who walks the floor. No, no, I can't wait. I will be there at 8 when they unlock the door.
Bond musical, or not the end of Act One. So if you guys don't know the story behind Legally Blonde, I really, really love it a lot. Because... yeah, hi, jump in the freeze frame. Because it's like a story about a girl, and she's like kind of a bimbo, right? I mean, I'm sure you guys have seen the movie. If you haven't, you should. She's kind of like a bimbo, right? And nobody really takes her seriously. But one day, she decides she wants to go to law school. And she gets in, and... not only does she get in, but none of the teachers and whatever are taking her seriously, right? Yes, we should do a watch along. None of the teachers are taking her seriously because of the way she looks, you know? And then she proves them all wrong, and she gets this big part, like not a part, but she gets this big like internship. And then a bunch of stuff happens, but she helps solve like a really big, not solve, she helps defend a big client. John Zero, thank you for the 20 gifted memberships. Please say thank you to John Zero if you got one. Thank you, 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 thank you. Now I'm like congested now somehow. Yay! Did you guys like it? I love that song. That's my favorite song from the Legally Blonde musical. Yeah. I recommend watching it. I think the whole musical is on YouTube if you guys are interested. So funny how Legally Blonde is one of the few legal-based shows movies that is fairly accurate to court compared to most others. It kind of is, but at the same time... the final case is like, not really. You wouldn't be able to just be like, hey, I just had an epiphany. And I'm an expert on perms. Like, you wouldn't be able to, they'd have to like, get a perm expert in, you know. But otherwise, I think it's pretty accurate, I think. They made a movie based on the musical and people were mad because they thought it was going to be a sequel to the old movie. There actually was a sequel to Legally Blonde, and it's really, really terrible. No, I didn't see it on stage, I saw it on YouTube. See you, Don Pavius. Is Legally... the original Legally Blonde movie is not a musical. No. Kinda rude? What's kinda rude? Okay, so that was... And I'm sure you guys know the part that I was not sure if I was gonna be able to do. I did kind of phone it in a little bit. So much better. Here we go. Jamal, thank you for the donation! Didn't Mommy say something about her voice not being in the best condition? I did, it's not. If she delivered that much power and soul, even a nerfed Ami is too powerful. Keep slaying, Queen! Yes, thank you so much! Lots of mom theme songs? No, there's not, there's just two. That I didn't know how you going Super Saiyan. Did it sound okay? I can't really hear myself when I sing because I don't use monitoring because I don't like the sound of my own voice. And I have these headphones on and it kind of blocks out that sound, you know. I nailed it, yay! Yay. Alright. Let's go on to the next song. Oh, this song. Can I play out Woods? Someone let me. I'd be a great Elle Woods. Oh no, then I have to be on stage. Can I be a VTuber and still be Elle Woods? Okay, this one I have to pitch down to. Alright. Now for a more serious. Not serious. Now for a more. You'll see. Hold on. Wait, does this start right away? Hold on. Okay, hold on. I gotta start over. When I grow up, I will be tall enough to reach the branches that I need to reach to climb the trees you get to climb when you're grown up. I grow up, I will be smart enough to answer all the questions that you need to know the answer to before you're grown up. And when I grow up, I will eat sweets every day on the way to work, and I will go to bed late every night. And I will wake up when the sun comes up, and I will watch cartoons until my eyes go square.
And I won't watch this until we all grown up. When I grow up,
it's so loud.
When I grow up, I will be strong enough. The heavy things you have to hold around with you when you're a grown up. And when I grow up, I will be brave enough to fight the creatures that you have to fight beneath the bed each night to be a grown up.
No, I didn't.
When I grow up, I will be brave enough to fight the creatures that you have to fight beneath the bed each night to be a grown up.
Just because you find that life's not fair, it doesn't mean that you just have to grin and bear it. If you always take it on the chin and wear it, nothing will change. Just because I find myself in this story, it doesn't mean that everything is written for me. If I think the ending is fixed already, I might as well be saying I think that it's okay. And that's not right. That's the end. Kind of an abrupt ending. Why is I messed up so bad? Oh god, what's happening? What is this? What's happening? Where is it? I fixed it. My falsetto was kind of struggling at the very moment. It's not even great at the best of times, but... I probably should have put that song earlier, but I kind of want it to be part of the finale, you know? But this is the actual finale. So I gotta get out the costume for this, and you guys will... Wait, come on. Turn around. We're all Shrek today. Oh, I have to add that to the set list. Hold on. Matilda. That one's from Matilda, by the way. Great musical. It's on Netflix now, too. Okay. Everyone calm down. Calm down. You guys like Shrek, right? Did you know there's a Shrek musical and it made me cry so much? It's very, very good. What key do I need this on? Plus one.
I guess I'd be a hero with sword and armor clashing, looking semi-dashing, a shield within my grip. Or else I'd be a Viking and live a life of daring while smelling like a herring. Upon a Viking ship I'd sail away, I'd see the world, I'd reach the farthest reaches. I'd feel the wind, I'd taste the salt and sea, and maybe storm some beaches. That's who I'd be. That's who I'd be. Oh, I could be a poet and write a different story, one that tells of glory and wipes away the lies. Into the skies I'd throw it, the stars would do the telling, the moon would help with spelling, and night would dot the eyes. I'd write a verse, recite a joke with wit and perfect timing. I'd share my heart, confess the things I heard, and do it all while rhyming. Hides. An ogre's fate is known. An ogre always stays in the dark and all alone. So yes, I'd be a hero, and if my wish were granted, a life would be enchanted. Oh, so the stories say. Of course I'd be a hero, and I would scale a tower. A hot house dweller, I'd carry her away, but standing guard would be a beast. I'd somehow overwhelm it. I'd get the girl, I'd take a breath, and I'd remove my helmet. Happy end.
ogre always hides. An ogre's fate is known. An ogre always stays in the dark and all alone. Life would be enchanted if so the storm stayed. Of course I'd be a hero, and I would scale a tower to save a hothouse flower and carry her away. This Shrek musical is so sad. You guys want them to watch it. I think it's still on Netflix. God, it's so sad. This song is so sad. It's so sad. Shrek had all these dreams and hopes, but he doesn't think he can do them because he's an ogre. He's like, I could be a poet. If I could do anything I want, maybe I'd be a poet. Or maybe I'd be a sailor. Or maybe I rescue a girl and get the girl. He's so sad. Shrek is about loving yourself. Yeah. Yeah, it's so good. I love Shrek and I'm not ashamed to say it. I can be the Shrek VTuber. I will not deny my responsibilities when it comes to being the Shrek VTuber. Can we make that happen? No, you didn't make me sad. Just the story makes me sad, you know. That was who I'd be. I love raw onions. I eat raw onions all the time. I ate raw onions yesterday. No sad mouth. No, that's not from a musical. I would like a hug. I don't know if I can handle defying gravity now. I am the Shrek Tupé. I love Shrek. I'm sorry, Shrek always makes me so sad. Especially that song, it like gives me literal goosebumps. Ugh. I'm not a handful, it's just a movie. It's just a musical. It's just a sad musical. Shrek week! There's enough Shrek games, probably. Alright, let's see, what do I have on my encore list that I can probably handle? I know. I'll sing Defying Gravity another time. It's, my voice is too, like, schwammed to do it right now. But I know what I can do. Do you want? Encore. You guys want encore, right? That was the last song, by the way, in the set list. But we can do more musical karaoke in the future. Encore! Encore! Yay! So this... I only know the movie version of this song. But I know they use it in the musical, which I think was a very, very good choice because... It's a really great song. It's from the second movie, actually. It's one of the rare second Disney movies that's like really good. Okay, hold on. I have lyrics too. Oh, God, Shrek. you say God Shrek without any context? It's not Terminator. Wait, let me check this. I have to say... Okay, never mind. Okay, I gotta restart. I have to say this part.
Ingunyama, ingunyama bara. Ingunyama, ingunyama bara. Night. And the spirit of life. Calling, oh, Iyo, Mamela, and a voice with the fear of a child answers, oh, Iyo, oh, Mamela. Ubukosi bokoko. When the nana sees the soul, okay, wait. There's no mountain too great. Hear the words and have faith. Oh, oh, oh. Have faith. Ella, himamela, ella, himamela, ella, himamela. He lives in you. He lives in me. He watches over everything we see. Into the water, into the truth. In your reflection, he lives in you. Ingunyama, ingunyama bala. He lives in you, he lives in you. He lives in me. He watches over everything we see.
I'm so over.
Into the truth. In your reflection, he lives in you. Wait. There's no mountain too great. Hear the words and have faith. He lives in you. He lives in me. He watches over everything we see. In your reflection. He lives in you. He lives in me. Oh, he watches over everything we see. Everything we see. Into the water. Into
last song for tonight. That is, he lives in you. from The Lion King. Now, I know every song from The Lion King and The Lion King 2 like the back of my hand. But the musical versions of the songs are like slightly different. So, if I messed that up, I apologize, but I really, 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 really wanted to sing some Lion King. That's all it was. And I'm sorry that I sang that with my Shrek ears on. I should not have done that. I kind of just forgot. Isn't this a musical only? No, it's from The Lion King too. Well, it's like a slightly different version, but He Lives in You is from The Lion King too. And it's a great song. Shrek lives in me. Shrek lives in all of us, okay. They added to the experience, okay, good, good, good. Does the musical have its own version? Be prepared. Probably? Probably. I don't know if it's that different though. It's hard to beat the one in the original Lion King. What if you don't want that? To have Shrek in you. You got that Shrek in you. You always are important part of any Solana ecosystem. True, true. And Simma wouldn't have succeeded without the power of Shrek. True, also. This is the first karaoke viewers I've seen. I just want to say you have such a perfect singing voice for musicals. It's so powerful and beautiful. Thank you. It's a quite, musical stuff is quite difficult for me. Stamina wise. But I could definitely do some other musical karaoke in the future. Including ones from musical movies. Yeah. But yeah, I guess shortest stream today, you guys, what karaoke's usually are. It's very, very difficult to sing for like 3 hours. There's a lot of singing. A lot of very intense singing. I came out of the gate with like a really, really difficult song. Even though it was low, it's like really comfortable range for me. Actually, I think I can probably do like, I can probably sing like male key songs for like a while. You know, once you throw in a like high, like freaking So Much Better, Legally Blonde, it's amazing that I was able to sing that late in the playlist. Theater songs are serious business, only a few types of singing that are tougher. Mm-hmm. Definitely. And even that's like forgetting the part that I'm not forgetting the part, but that's like excluding the part that like when you're on actual stage you have to like belt and like emote and stuff, and it's really, really tough. You did great, thank you. You have a wonderful voice, always amazing and surprising to listen to you sing. Thank you. Anyway, happy Friday, you guys. I forgot to say that to you guys. Happy Friday. Hope you guys have a great weekend. I am still streaming tomorrow. I'm gonna be streaming Metal Gear Solid 2. It's been very, very fun. I've seen professional stage performances of some of these songs that did not sound as... Don't say that! That's not true. Okay, I was really proud how I did with So Much Better though. Very proud of that, so... I'll take the compliment. I'll take the compliment. Director, no. Yeah. Thank you to the... I accept. Thank you to the archivists who are hopefully archiving this. I really, really, really... Ah, stop! You guys are so funny. I put a lot of work into my team. And singing always feels good to me no matter what, you know? It's one of those things where it's like, no matter how bad of a mood I'm in, I can always sing. It makes me feel better, you know? Big hug. Thank you for the 17 months, Marv. Thank you for your amazing karaoke. I'm so lovely. Thank you, guys. Gentle, thank you very much for the very generous donation. Absolutely amazing karaoke, Ami. Ami, love. Mako, love. Thank you guys so much. For supporting all this different crazy stuff I do. and for always recognizing my hard work, you know? Laz and Finger for the 19 months. You did great. Thanks for entertaining me at work. I hope it was entertaining. and I hope you guys had a good time. And I'm sorry I did not get to more of your guys' requests. It was hard to learn new songs. I learned a lot though. Alive, Modern Major General, When You Go to Mama, Then Mom, Epiphany, Any Dream Will Do, Shapoopy. I learned all of those for this karaoke. Boron, thank you for the 7 months. Good night, Ami. Loved it. Thank you so much. Good night. Red Ranger, thank you for the 5 gifted memberships. Please say thank you. We got one from Red Ranger. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. And thank you, Nichimon, for the 7 months. Your voice is fantastic, but we'll always appreciate all the hard work you do for us. Ami, love, thank you so much. I know you guys do, I know you guys do. Never once have I felt not appreciated, you know? A lot of these were my first time properly singing them, yeah. Yeah. Peppermint, thank you so much for the donation as well. Ami, love, thank you for everything you do. That was a wonderful performance. I'm glad if it was wonderful. If I did good by you guys, then I did good. Sometimes I feel like, you know, like before I was like, my voice is not in the best shape, but I'll do my best. And then, like, probably it's not up to snuff for me, but as long as it's up to snuff for you guys, that's all that matters. Nothing's up to snuff. Nothing I do is up to snuff for me, let's be honest. Terrible, thank you for the 10 gifted memberships. Thank you so much. Please say thank you to Turbo if you got one. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Siesta, thank you so much for the super chat. Thanks for the show. You're welcome, very welcome. And Lupus also gifted some. Thank you so much, Lupus, for the 5 gifted memberships. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Nice. I love this sniff. Yeah. This is, singing is a workout, okay? Cat Plus, thanks for the 21 months. Wonderful singing is always happy. Shrek watches over us all, so he dies, so he dies. Hero, thanks for the 14 months. Singing Spider Love, thank you for sharing your voice with us. Thank you guys for enjoying it. I appreciate you guys so much. Alright, I'm gonna go rest my voice for tomorrow for Melgar Solid 2 tomorrow. Yoketo Kato, thank you for the 4 months. Ami love, if that got you. And Scup, thank you so much for the super chat. Amazing karaoke again. Ami, some of the songs really hit me in the feels. Me too. Love your wonderful singing always. Thank you. Akatsuki, thank you so much for the 21 months. Thank you for the lovely singing over 21 months of pure fun. Ami love, buckle love. Thank you, Red Ranger, for the rose. yeah, I'm gonna rest my voice for Metal Gear Solid tomorrow. I can barely talk. How did I freaking sing that Major General song? I am the very model of a modern Major General. How did I do that? How can I rap? I can barely talk. Alright, you guys, thank you so much. I'm gonna head off. And I will... I'll make sure to rest my voice. I'm gonna have a good chat day meal. I got a slice of... Dolce de leche cake waiting for me. Okay. And, yeah. Yeah. So... I'll see you guys tomorrow, I hope. Have a great Friday, otherwise. Thank you very much for hanging out, everyone who stopped in. Thank you to all my regulars and irregulars and everyone who stopped by for the first time. I don't do karaoke super often, but when I do, I go all out, okay? And thank you so much to all the VOD watchers and VOD commenters and the chatters and lurkers. And thank you so much to all my Dream Reavers and Buckles and Spire Links. And everybody who gifted memberships and donated and joined the memberships and renewed your memberships this stream. Appreciate you guys a lot. A lot. More than you know, okay? And I'll see you tomorrow for some comfy gaming time to end off the week, okay? Yay! Kaisamiya, oyasumiya, bye bye!